Hi, my name is Andrew Paine. This last April, fellow Sitka activist Kelsey Street and I traveled to Heiltsuk Territory in the heart of the Great Bear Rainforest. We were there to volunteer with Pacific Wild, a remarkable organization based out of Bella Bella with aims of protecting this truly wild place. We spent the next handful of days aboard Habitat, the floating research lab dedicated to studying this coast, and got a glimpse into the life of what this team leads. This was not a random time to make this trip out to the coast. It was my 35th birthday, and this was herring season. The coast boils to life as this keystone species returns to spawn in the inlets, bays, and islands where they had hatched. Pacific herring mature after 3 to 4 years, and at that time they'll come back and spawn for the very first time. If allowed to live, these small fish will come back to the same spot year after year after year, and can spawn up to 12 times each. It is truly incredible the amount of life that shows up for this big event. It's hard to find a fish-eating species that does not benefit from the spawn, with everything from sea lions, whales, dolphins, birds, wolves, and bears all relying on the annual herring return. Aside from the salmon return in the autumn, there is no other natural event on the coast that brings such a bounty of action and life. The modern commercial sacro, gillnet, and seine fisheries kill the fish for the eggs and the body for the fish farm food. It's not hard to see why this is not a sustainable method. While we were there, we were truly fortunate enough to see a more sustainable way of accessing this natural resource as members of the Heiltsuk First Nation harvested rowan hemlock boughs that had been placed in the water, as been done for thousands of years. This harvesting method ensures that the herring will return year after year, since there is no harm done to the fish whatsoever, and a small portion of the total eggs laid in the water are actually harvested. It was an incredible experience with a calmness in the air. This could not have been a more different scene than the controversial commercial sacro fishery that had taken place and then had been halted by the will of the Heiltsuk Nation only days before. The irony of the situation really struck me as I looked over the side of the boat to see thousands of herring boiling directly under the bows that were being pulled from the water. These fish really will be back next year to spawn again. That evening, in a bay not far away, we witnessed the spawn in all its glory. The females that had been staging for days were finally coating everything in sight with a thick layer of eggs, while the males turned the water a cloudy white with their milt. It was truly a magical night to witness such an event with an amazing group of people who share my passion for this small but mighty fish. This will truly be a birthday I will never forget. Thank you for watching.